Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming channel. So in this video, I want to share 10 tips about NeuroCloud, especially for those who want to progress quite fast in the beginning, especially for FTP. But yeah, spenders might want to know these tips too. But before that, I want to say thank you to LD Player for sponsoring this video. As you can see here, I'm using LD Player to play NeuroCloud. Yeah, play in bigger screen using LD Player in PC. As you guys already know, I've been using LD Player for my Nikkei. Yeah, it is basically very smooth. It is also very smooth in this NeuroCloud. So I would recommend you guys to try LD Player playing NeuroCloud in PC on a bigger screen like this. I will put the download link in the description below. Hopefully, you guys download NeuroCloud using that link, because I will get something from them if you guys download it using that link. Maybe a little candy for me? Okay. You can do it for free, download it for free, and I will get something from them. That's going to help me. Okay, the first tip is about how to level up your characters. Obviously, do EXP dungeon like this. If you're lacking of EXP, just go press here, go to the EXP dungeon, spam this. As I mentioned in yesterday's video, you need to do normal quests to unlock the higher level of this EXP dungeon. So you have to push your normal quest, the story mode, this one. Try to keep doing this standard mode until you are stuck. What I mean with stuck is, well, actually in the beginning you won't get stuck. The one that will make you stuck is the stamina. What I mean with stuck is, when you actually reach max level like this, I mean level 40, you have to do breakthrough, right? And then you realize that you are going to need this, for example, purple material. And if you check it here, you need to beat stage 315 to get this, yeah, so that you can start to farm the purple material. So once you max out the EXP, somehow you need to go to breakthrough, like for example level 40. If I want to go to level 50, I will need this purple material, right? So what I usually do is I'm just going to raise all of these characters to level 40, then start keep pushing the normal story again until you can unlock the material you need to break through the character like this. Yeah, if needed, you can replenish your stamina with keycards or replenish with Squad Sense, which I actually did. For this one, I only recommend doing this maybe only on the first week or maybe on the first few days, because you will need to unlock a lot of stuff like factory, you will need to clear stage 3-6, and you will need to unlock a lot of features in the beginning. And the second tip is about the short shot. Basically, you can get this by doing gacha, right? So it is very, very precious. My recommendation is do not use it now yet, because all of these characters are actually farmable. Yes, you can farm the shards for free by doing this fragment search every day. Yeah, it's only 10 attempts per day. Yeah, I already explained this to you yesterday. So do not buy the shards yet. Yeah, save it for the characters that is not farmable. Well, if it's in the China version, the non-farmable character is something like Clocky, and she is very good. So you might want to save this, especially if you're F2P. If you're a spender, obviously it is okay. Just do it, whatever you want. And then to get faster shards, you can do this every day. Vulnerability check, because it will give you this. Drop 100 to 130. This is it. You can check on special supplies. Vulnerability check. Okay, I got 330 already, and I can spend it for shards. So this is the shop where you should buy your shards. You can actually break through earlier by using this, but I don't really recommend on buying these materials, because you will be able to get this like easily later with stamina. So I will recommend you guys to spend your glitter chip for shards. Which shards should you try to buy? If it's in this list, I would recommend Croak, of course. Just buy this one. Yeah, this will help you to get Croak 5 stars much faster. And then the fourth tip. This is probably most of beginners are kind of not even realize it. So go here on the top left, set your support duel. Yeah. Why do you have to do this? Because here, there is support exchange in the shop. You can get the points by setting and loaning out support duels, earn reputation points, okay? which can be spent in the shop. So basically you will get summon ticket from this, which is the best reward in this shop. And also you can get skill pivot. You will need to raise the doll's skill level later. And the others are kinda totally optional. And then, here on the character, you can see it here. Story. Basically, you can unlock this by raising the intimacy level. How to raise the intimacy level? You can basically give the character gift like this. You will be able to raise a character's intimacy. And you will be able to unlock these extra stats, but you have also to raise the characters first, as you can see here. Why this is important? Because, well, especially for spenders. Yeah, usually spenders will just go spend their gems on gacha and then get a lot of characters, and then they'll just going to buy the shards on the shard shop, right? Like, for example, this one. Most of the spenders will do this. Okay, before you actually buy the shards, you might want to count how many shards you can get here before you actually buy, because you might overbuy the shards if you didn't count how many shards you can buy here. And yeah, for F2P, of course, it is a faster way to raise the character stars. And then after you progress quite far, you will be able to unlock this algorithm. Yep. Basically, this will give you extra stats and stuff. And you can also upgrade the algorithm efficiency, like this one, into 110%. And my power will get increased, for example like this. Now 120%. This blue color is actually the normal rarity. There will be purple and there will be yellow for this. Yellow is the highest if I'm not wrong. And also you can customize the character stats by doing this. How to farm those algorithm? Here, go to algorithm collection. If you want to unlock the higher level, you have to push the normal story again. It will get unlocked on stage 312. And the 7 tips, it's on the gacha. Here, on the basic search, if you look at here, basically, the 2 stars and 3 stars doll will be available once I upgrade the Oasis search terminal. Here it is, on the Oasis search terminal. If I upgrade it into the level 5, Banshee and Gin will be added to the search pool. So yeah, do not choose Banshee or Gin on the selection pool. Yeah, basically don't do it now. Do it after you raise your Oasis terminal, reach level 5. Or yeah, if it's reach 40, just spend it 10. And then if it's reach another 40, spend another 10. And so on. And the tips number 8 is, of course, to raise your character even stronger, you need to raise your character skill. And once again, if you want to access this feature, you have to unlock it. You have to do the normal story, the standard mode, into stage 4-4 to unlock this. This will make your character even stronger later. And the tips number 9. I got a question about this before, actually. You know this Persicaria is actually moving and talking, right? Here, on the middle part, you can press here. And basically, you can set the character that you want to showcase here. We can change the background like this. And also, we can change the assistant. The question was, if I use another character like this, why this one doesn't move? Okay, here is why. Actually, in order to make it move, you have to have this live 2D, right? So how to unlock that live 2D here on the costume? Okay, default projection, it's not moving. But here, the live 2D, you have to unlock this. How? Via neural expansion. Basically, raise the character star. You will be able to unlock this. This one, yeah. So that's how to unlock the live 2D for your lobby. And the tips number 10 is actually not a tips. It is redeem code. Go to the top right, this, redemption code. The first one is this, NC42 lab. Ooh, nice. Skill pivot and combat EXP. The second redemption code is this, NC1121. Ooh, EXP skill point. And also gift, yellow gift, So yeah, only two codes. Actually, I was about to enter another three codes, but they didn't work. So that's all for today's tips. So yeah, if you want to watch more neural code video, please subscribe, press the like button, and see you again next time. Bye bye, Ushi Punch.